I am Nataraja Upadhyaya. Welcome to Ashrama Gardens, Urban Evergreen Jungle. Urban Evergreen Jungle is not a rocket science. It's a very simple concept. Like any other jungle, it is having an evergreen jungle in an urban landscape. In our case, it is our home called Ashrama. As you can see here, we create green space in four distinct layers. The topmost layer is on the terrace. The green on the terrace is the topmost layer. Then the inside compound, the green that originates from inside compound is the second layer. Then the green coming out of the outside compound. Here in this case, we are growing through the bins, still keeping space for the footpath for people to use and walk, is the third layer. Let us go inside the compound now. Here I want to show what we did last year. Within 3 months, we are able to create a cave on our staircase using very flimsy support. The thumbergia we are growing acts as a cover, a nice cover, creating a cave structure under it. So when we go through the staircase, it becomes a special experience. Now we are on the terrace. Before I show you around, I want to talk about two major fears which stops any enthusiast from creating a jungle like this on their landscape. One fear is of the weight, whether the terrace can take the weight. The second one, which is the most important, is the fear of water damage. I would like to say that both are unnecessary negative myths, and they can be easily tackled with. For example, our building is 32-year-old building. It is a concrete structure without pillars. That means all the weight is on the walls, brick walls. So here what we have done is, we have put the weight on the brick walls. That way we have managed the approximately around 25 tons of this weight on a old building. This terrace jungle is made up of around 220 bins, recycled plastic bins like this. If you notice, each bin, which is from 55 liters and above, is a micro jungle by itself. Interspersed with the bin-based jungles, we have water gardens, again made using recycled materials like this. This is a bathtub, which is recycled. The water gardens primarily need direct sun, and it has lot of mud. It is a self-sustained environment. That means we have fish here so that mosquito breeding doesn't happen. In an urban landscape, when you are having a restricted space, you can still work around it to create a thick jungle. One technique is to go for creepers. Second technique is to go for trees that take less space, narrow space, but can grow taller. For the naked eye, this jungle may look cluttered and mindless, but there is a lot of thought that is gone into this. This jungle supports different types of plants. It could be edible plants like this. It could be ornamental plants like this. It could be certain herbal plants, flower plants. It could be even food-yielding trees like agathi tree here. It could be various beans. And it could be certain specific plants meant for conservation purpose only. So there is a variety of plants here, which when put together creates a jungle effect. But there is a lot of utility value, conservation value, and happiness value. Hope this visit helped you to understand what a basic urban evergreen jungle can be. Like to highlight though, that there is a difference between looking at a jungle and making it yourself. I would like to say, making it yourself is not difficult. You should be committed to it, and it's highly enriching and rewarding. You will have your life enriched at the levels of body, mind, heart and spirit, and that you will have a paradise created by you, for you and for the rest, not only humans, all kind of beings, bees, butterflies and other mammals. I hope you will commit to urban evergreen jungle in your space. Thank you for your time. Have a good one. Bye bye.